Okay, I'm going to run through this packet tracer lab, the 2233 configuring initial switch settings. If you go down through here and you read the objectives, these are the kinds of things that we're going to configure. The first step says to enter privilege mode, so it says to click S1 and then the CLI tab. So let's go to S1. We're going to go to CLI. Let's see. Press your enter key to get to the switch prompt. Type enable. Press enter. And you're at the pound sign, which is configuration mode. The next thing it wants us to do is show running config. And we can see the current configurations that are on the switch now. I'm going back over here to the instructions, and it says for you to look to see how many Ethernet interfaces, gigabit, so forth. The next step says to create a basic switch configuration. Assign a name to the switch. When you see the more command here, you press the space bar, and you'll get to the end so you can get back to the pound sign, which is privilege mode. And in order for us to do this configuration, we have to enter configuration mode. So I'm going to type in configure terminal. Or you can do config T. We're going to do hostname S1. And we're going to type exit. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to put a secure access to the console line. Again, we're going to do configure terminal, which you know by now that you can do a shortcut, config T, and that puts you in configuration mode. And here, make sure your prompt matches the prompt that's in the instructions here. We're going to type in line console 0, and notice the prompt change. We're going to type in password, let me in. We're going to type in login next and exit, and then exit one more time. So now we've put a line console password on the switch. Verify that console access is secured. So press your enter key, make sure you're at the correct prompt. We're going to type in exit, and we're going to press the enter key, and it says excuse me, to type in the password that we originally set on this console line, which is let me in, and press enter. And I'm back at the S1 greater than, or the user prompt, which is mine matches that. The next thing it wants us to do is to set the enable password. So we have to go escalate our access from user mode to privilege mode, and we do that by typing in enable. And at the pound sign, we have to do config T. Next thing we're going to do is enable password, and that is C1 dollar sign C0. Press enter. Type in exit, and we should be back at the switch prompt. Alright, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to verify that the privilege mode access is secure. We're basically going to verify what we just did. So what we're going to do now is we're going to exit out. We are back at the privilege, at the user prompt. Remember, the first password we set at the console prompt was let me in. So now I should get another password prompt for the second password I put in, which is for the privilege, access to the privilege mode. Type in enable. The password I put in there was C1 dollar sign C0. And notice it let me in. So far everything is good. Okay, now we're going to go down to the next prompt, and we are going to put an encrypted password to secure access to privilege mode. So come back over here to the switch, Going to type in config t. Enable secret. It's a secret. And type exit. Alright, we're back at the switch pound sign now. And now we need to verify that the enable secret password is in the configuration file. So we're going to type in show run, which is shortcut for show run and config. If you look through here, you should see you have an enable secret password and it is encrypted. You have a enable password, which is C1 $C0. So far everything looks as it should. There's your console password. Let me in. So let's come back over here and come down to this next part. Encrypt the enable password and console password. This is another level of encryption that we can add to these passwords. This is so that they don't show in plain text. So we're going to go back over here and do config t. And we're going to type in the command service space password dash encryption. And notice I got an error message where you see that little caret symbol. I misspelled that. Anytime you see a caret symbol and you get this invalid input, it means you've typed a syntax error. The caret symbol shows you exactly where that problem is. So I'm going to press my up arrow. And I'm going to come over here and correct this. And it looks like I got too many W's. Alright, that should do it. So I'm going to press enter and it took my service password encryption. I'm going to type in exit and go on to part 3. Configure a message of the day banner. Excuse me. So at the prompt here, I'm going to type in config t, and I'm going to start this text message of the day with a pound sign, and I'm going to type in the command banner motd space open quotes, this is a secure system. Authorize access only. And put a quick exclamation point and close parentheses. And I'm going to press the enter key. And it should have taken my configuration. If you look here, it says it just shows you that you did put the configuration online. Alright, so part 4 says for us to save these configurations that we've done so far, we're going to type in exit. Press the enter key to get back to the prompt. Anytime you make switch configurations or router configurations, unless you save them as soon as they power cycle, those settings are going to go away. So the command to save what you've done so far is copy running config startup config. Running config startup. These are default configuration file names that are stored on the NVRAM chip on the inside of the router. So you can't deviate from these file names. So this is the correct naming convention. Copy running config to startup config means copy what you have in running memory and load it onto a file on the NVRAM chip and call it startup config. Just notice I misspelled that. Press enter and it's asking you for the destination file name, and that is the correct destination file name, so we're going to press enter there. Alright, so now we're going to go on to this next step, and it wants us to examine the configuration file. Alright, so let's do show run. And in his, what we should see is that we have a enable secret password that's showing encrypted. the enable password, guess what? Last time we looked at this, before we put the encryption on it, this was showing in plain text. It's no longer showing in plain text, which is what we want. I'm going to press enter so I can look at the rest of the commands. Here is the message of the day that we put in. Here we have the console password. Notice the last time we looked at this, it was in text, plain text. It's now encrypted. And that should be all the configurations that we have. Let's see. So now let's do configure switch 2. Let's see. So I'm going to need to get out of this. And let's come over here to switch 2. Go to the command line interface. Press the enter key. And let's see. I'm going to type enable. And we're going to do the commands to configure this second switch. It says name the device S2. So I'm going to go into configuration mode. And I'm going to type in hostname S2. Alright, I'm back at my config prompt. And now it says configure and enable password. So I'm going to type in now enable. Secret C1$C0. We need to do a message of the day. The command to do that was banner MOTD. So I'm going to type in banner MOTD, open quotes, this is a secure system. Authorized users only. And close it with the quotes. So we've done that. It says encrypt all plain text passwords, and the way we do that is enable. I'm sorry, let me back up for a second. Let me think about that. This is going to be enable service password encryption. And notice that I have a caret symbol there, so I have my command incorrect. So let's do service. Let me delete this. Okay, my up arrow again. And I think I just need to type in service password encryption. And it took it that time because I didn't get an error message. And then it says ensure the configuration is correct and then save it. So what we're going to do now is exit out, show run, and we're going to look to make sure our secret password, our enable secret password, is encrypted. It didn't ask us to put any passwords here, I don't think, unless I went past it. But so far it looks like what we've put on here is correct. Something I want to point out too, if you don't follow these instructions exactly, you won't get your completion rate up to 100%. And I just noticed that I didn't put my message of the day in here correctly. So my packet trace is not going to add up to 100%, but I'm not going to go back and correct it simply because I don't want this video to be too long. But when you do complete any of these packet traces, if you do any of these commands out of sequence, what's going to happen is your completion rate is going to be off. If you want this to be 100%, go through and do everything exactly the way Cisco asks you to do it here in the instructions, in sequential order, step-by-step order. But again, mine's not going to add up to 100% because I've not done the commands exactly as it's stated in the instructions. All right, we're supposed to save this, so let's do copy. And rather than doing copy, running config, startup config, we're going to do a shortcut, which is copy, run, start. And that's just notice the same file name. That's just a shortcut command. All right. Now, I've only got 51% here. And I know the reason, pardon me, that I only have 50% is, as I said earlier, there's a couple things I didn't do that I should have done. So we can do check results, and we can look at our activity results, assessment items, and we can look at the things that we didn't do correctly. So if you look in here, I didn't do a on my switch 2, I didn't do a console line, I didn't do an enable password, I didn't do a host name, although I thought I did. But let's go back over here and let's look at these instructions again. And let's see, close out of that. Let me get back to the instructions and see if I can increase my percentage a little bit here. Let's see. Let me go back down to switch 2 because that's where the problems for me seem to be. Let's see. Alright, message of the day, that was on switch 1, so we need to go down a little further. Alright, configure switch 2. Alright, it told us to name the device. Let me go back over here to switch 2, go to the command line. It said to name the device S2, which we did. That's done. It says protect access to the console using the let me in password. That's a step that I didn't do. That's part of why my configuration or my percentage of completion is not correct. So let's go back and let's see if we can do that. And if you don't remember what the commands are, you can come back up here, find where the commands are. And I would suggest you write these commands down because going forward, what's going to happen is you're going to need to know how to do all this stuff by heart. All right, so what we're going to do is go into config T. And we're going to type in line console 0, password let me in. Log in, exit, exit. Also, something else I didn't do. Notice my percentage went up when I went in and corrected that. Let's see. We were also on the switch 2 supposed to set a privilege mode. Excuse me. So I'm going to now go back into config T, and I'm going to do enable password. C1$C0. Okay, here's where one of the problems is. Because I skipped this step originally and I went straight to putting a service password encryption command in here, I can't go back and do this part of the layout. So I've got to undo that service password encryption so that I can complete this step on the switch. So I'm going to turn off what I turned on a few minutes ago by entering the no password encryption, no service password encryption. Now I should be able to put this enable password on though. We're already there. So I'm going to do enable password C1$C0. Let's see. This is not recommended. Please re-enter the enable password. Alright, let me try that again. Enable password C1$C0. Got the same message. Let me exit out. And let me do show run. Enable secret. Enable password. So the enable password is on now. And I may have to get this back down by typing it by undoing the secret that I put in there. This is a classic reason why you should go through these. I was trying to go through this lab too fast. to try to get you going on the lab. And because I did that, I skipped around and I didn't complete these steps in sequential order. And rather than make this video too long, I'm going to skip out of this and let you go through this lab and make sure you follow it step by step. It may be helpful to print the instructions out. You can do that by right-clicking in the box. I thought you could do it here. I thought you could right-click and print, but obviously you can't. Let's see, is there a way up here I can print it? No, won't let me print from within inside of here. But you can print these instructions out by going to the online curriculum, and also I think I have a folder set up in Moodle that has the instruction files for this reason. So print these instructions out and just check mark them off as you go. That way you won't skip anything, because I skipped right over part of this and I'm only at 55%. So I can either give up now, save this and turn it in and get a 55 on it, or I can either go back and fix this. Now I would make another suggestion. If you do skip like I did, because the way the grading occurs on these packet tracers, what I would do is start this assignment all over again rather than to try to fix what I have done, because now Packet Tracer has noticed that I have skipped around these commands and it's not going to really take me fully to 100%, even if I undo and redo and undo and redo commands because I did them out of sequence. Packet Tracer still is not going to grade it correctly. So the best thing to do is to start the whole assignment over and get the commands put in the way they're supposed to. Anyway, that's how you would complete this command. Be very mindful of these commands when you type them in. Make sure you type the passwords in the way that they're asking them here. Make sure you enter them, because we got three passwords on this one so far. We got a console password, enable password, a secret password. Make sure that when you're logging in that you understand which password it is you need to type in. All right, so I'm going to end this video, and good luck on the assignment.